Well, thank you. A man charged with going into a Walmart and stabbing his estranged wife on Saturday could soon be standing in front of a judge. News 4's Myra Ruiz is live and local at the Law Enforcement Center in Greenville. Myra.
Well, Nigel, 47-year-old Avery Blandin is charged with murder in the death of his wife. The Greenville County Sheriff's Office continues to investigate what led to the stabbing death of Lilia Blandin. But court documents suggest there was a violence in the relationship before Saturday.
Around 1:20 Saturday afternoon, deputies were called to the Walmart on White Horse Road. Lilia Blandin worked at a branch of Wood Forest National Bank inside the store. According to deputies, Mr. Blandin came in, quarreled with his wife, and then stabbed her with a knife.
But there were a couple of shoppers and employees in the store who were at least made an attempt to try to intervene. Unfortunately, they were unsuccessful.
Deputies took Avery Blandin into custody and to the hospital after he crashed his car down the road.
We're still trying to piece certain pieces of the investigation together.
Back in July of 2010, Mr. Blandin was charged with criminal domestic violence. The warrant states that he struck his wife with a closed fist and caused visible injury. The case was never prosecuted after Mrs. Blandin signed an affidavit saying that she wanted the case dismissed and that she was not willing to cooperate with prosecutors. Then in October of this year, Blandin was charged with CDV again. The warrant states that he punched his wife in the mouth and stomach after he accused her of cheating. Deputies took note of the swollen upper lip. The warrant also states that Mrs. Blandin told deputies she feared for her safety and the safety of her children. She and her husband had three children together, and now there's a case of homicide.
Really trying to determine why someone would do something like this.
Avery Blandin is technically in the custody of the detention center officers. He could go before a judge as early as tonight. Now, over the weekend, a Walmart spokesperson said that the store made sure operations did not get in the way of investigations. No one returned calls to explain today why specifically why the store decided to stay open. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4, live in the digital studio.